Today we are going to study mitosis and meiosis. You all know that living organisms are made up of cells. But how do they grow? How do they multiply or give rise to the next generation? The answer is all living organisms show a unique feature of cell division. So today let's know more about cell division in living organisms through this experiment. Higher plants and animals show two types of cell divisions, namely mitosis and meiosis. Before we study mitosis and meiosis as processes, let's find out how are these different from each other. When we say that a plant or a child is growing tall or growing big in size or the wound has healed, in all these cases, the new cells are formed by mitosis. On the other hand, when the seed germinates to form a new plant or female gives birth to a young one, the type of cell division that occurs is meiosis. New cells are formed by mitosis. They are very much similar or identical to their parent cells. But when new generation is born through meiosis, they differ from their parents. That is why we humans in any family are not the Xerox copies of our ancestors. But still, we share some common features. In mitosis and meiosis, there are two stages in process. They are karyokinesis, that is nothing but the division of the nucleus, and cytokinesis, that is nothing but division of cytoplasm. Now let us see the requirements. We need permanent slides of mitosis and meiosis, a compound microscope. Onion roots can be easily grown and they can be used for mitosis. For meiosis, anthers from the flower buds or cells from the testes or insects like grasshopper are suitable materials. Now let us see the observations. In mitosis, karyokinesis is further divided into prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. Students, all these stages appear little different from your textbook diagrams. So, please observe them carefully. Prophase. Nuclear membrane and nucleolus begin to disappear. Thin threads of chromatin start becoming short and thick to form chromosomes along with their sister chromatids. Centrioles divide and migrate to opposite poles of the cells. This happens only in the animal cells. Metaphase. Nuclear membrane and nucleolus disappear completely. There is further thickening of chromosomes. Chromosomes get arranged at equatorial plane of the cell. And this is a key feature to identify the metaphase. Spindle fibers arise in cytoplasm and get attached to centromeres of the chromosomes. Usually, counting of chromosomes is done at metaphase. Anaphase. In this phase, centromeres split and sister chromatids separate from each other. Spindle fibers begin to contract and pull sister chromatids to opposite poles of the cell. Telophase. This phase is said to be reverse of the prophase. Migration of sister chromatids is complete. Spindle fibers disappear completely. The chromosomes form thin threads of chromatin. Nuclear membrane and nucleolus reappear. Now the cell has two daughter nuclei at opposite poles. Now karyokinesis is complete, which is followed by cytokinesis. In cytokinesis, cytoplasm divides to form two new daughter cells. In plants, there is a cell plate. And in animal cell, it is a cell notch formed during the cytokinesis. The chromosome number of parent and daughter cells remains equal. Meiosis. In meiosis, cell divides in two stages as meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. So, at the end of the process, four haploid cells are formed. The chromosome number of the parent cell, that is a diploid cell, is reduced exactly to the half in meiosis 1. Meiosis 2 is similar to mitosis where the reduced chromosome number is kept constant. Meiosis 1 it is subdivided into prophase 1, metaphase 1, anaphase 1 and telophase 1. Prophase 1, this is the longest and the most important phase of meiosis. It shows further subphases. Leptotin, a thin thread stage. Zygotin, pairing of homologous chromosomes to form bivalence. Pachytin, this is a crossing over stage and chiasmata is formed. Diplotin, separation of chromosomes after recombination. Diakinesis, separation of chromosomes is complete. Nuclear membrane and nucleolus disappear. Metaphase 1, homologous chromosomes get arranged at equatorial plane of the cell. Spindle fibers arise in cytoplasm and get attached to centromeres of the chromosomes. Anaphase 1, homologous chromosomes migrate to opposite poles of the cell. This is disjunction. Telophase 1, chromosomes reach opposite poles of the cell. Nuclear membrane and nucleolus reappear. Cytokinesis 1, cytoplasm divides to form two haploid daughter cells. Meiosis 2, it is similar to mitosis. The haploid chromosomes remain constant in all four daughter cells.